Hi everyone, thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe. So today we're going to be talking about how to create monochromatic looks using two different strategies. So we have monochrome with print and regular monochrome. Picking a print can be the hardest part. So you want to find a print that matches a color similar to what you want to wear on the bottom. So for this, I chose this skirt. This skirt actually came from Olar's Grace. I will tag it below. It comes as a set with a matching blazer, but for right now, I'm just wearing the skirt. I had it altered so that it fits well around my waist, whereas it fits more wide around my hips. This is a size 2X or a UK 18 on me, and I just had it altered to fit my waist better. Don't forget about your alterationist lady, she's the real MVP. Now to accessorize this look, I want to add some shoes that are in the green family, but not necessarily the same color. So these shoes I got from Shop Akira. I know they look a lot like Tom Ford's disco platforms, but they were only about $90. Azalea Wang is the name of the shoe designer. But yes, these are not as tall, so they're actually a little bit more comfy for someone like me. I'm just gonna put them on here, speed this up a little bit. And now I have them on. So as you can see, the green is not the same as the other greens, but it is in the green family, which is what we want for this type of monochromatic look. Now, fun fact, the reason I got these shoes was to match this green Croc Staud Moon bag that I got from their sample sale last year. Oh, I just love how they match. Even though they're not like the same exact green, both them being green Croc is just so perfect. So now that I have the purse and the shoes, I got the green from the skirt that matches part of the green in the shirt. And there's like a little dark green in the shirt that matches the shoes. It all plays in together. So we also want to add a coat. Let's get that coat. I actually got this coat from Zara. Just wanted a nice green coat, and honestly everything else I wanted was sold out or too expensive. And the Zara coat just gave me the green I was looking for. Also pairs kind of with this shirt. Just a little bit, maybe. I'm not really sure, but green, green, green. We're cute, right? Yes, we are cute. Now, one thing that's great about this coat and this look is that everything is slightly bigger than the size I would normally select. That way it gives me space underneath the coat and with the skirt to move around and do all these crazy things. I'm wearing a double XL in this coat. It's from Zara again. However, this is a Japanese sizing, so know that it might be different if you buy it in a different country. This top is from Kai Collective, and it is a size large. It's very stretchy because it's mesh. And the skirt, once again, is a size 2XL, also a UK 18 from Olar's Grace. Now, let's change into this dress. It is from Zara. Let's go get a blazer. Now I'm choosing a blazer that matches the color of the dress somewhat. They're around the same family of green. Have a nice little brooch just to, you know, spice up the blazer. It's important when trying to do a monochromatic look where all the colors match that you pick colors in the same exact family. So this whole grass green, true green type is the color I'm going for. These shoes came from Zara. You can kind of see the name engraved into the shoe, or pressed in. I don't remember how much these cost, but I'll put it down below. So yeah, so these shoes are like a cloth material and they are slingbacks, but they do match the kind of green, grass green you're trying to go for. Now, although these shoes are super comfortable because of the heel height, they are sling back, so they do tend to fall off the back while you are walking. I try to keep my foot back a little bit just to keep it tight. But of course, you will probably end up having to fix it. Now, another thing I like to do with a blazer as oversized and boxy as this, this is actually the blazer from the matching skirt. I like to roll up the sleeves just to make sure that I am accentuating my waistline and I don't look too oversized per se, like a big giant square box, instead giving slightly hourglass with wide shoulders, thinner waist, and then wide hips. We do wanna add a bag. The bag that I'm going to choose to go with this look is the mini Bottega Veneta Jody bag. I got this bag on a flash sale at My Teresa. I think the grass green color is just so perfect to go with this look, especially with the color of the shoes. It all really just fits in well together. So which kind of monochromatic fan are you? Are you one to wear similar colors, or would you throw in a print or two? I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give me a like and a subscribe, especially if you want to see more style inspo and more different style tips and just fashion advice in general on this channel. I hope you enjoy. Bye.